ekhiwani iqaqa laqabele qaqa lizigqaqa ngomhlana qaqa iqaqa lenze vala ucanga ucace le ngithege ngothe qaqa ngithenga ixesha ixesha lexa kwaqhalabela uqamba phaqulana
Humans, we do not come in peace. We come to exterminate you. You swat at us. You step on us. You poison us. You commit genocide against entire populations of our species, but yet you want us to have mercy on you. No. We do not come in peace. We will swarm on you. We come for your extermination. Thousands of years ago, when human beings were in tune with nature, we insectoids and insectilians lived in harmony with human beings. Back then, humans even adopted us as their gods. Insectoids like Khepri, the scarab beetle of ancient Egypt, Selket, the scorpion goddess of ancient Egypt, the Egyptian scorpion king, Anansi the spider, and Mylitta, the Madam Mother Butterfly, the goddess of Mesopotamia, were all insectoids and insectilians who humans held as gods. This is why angels and fairies are depicted with insectoid butterfly wings, because there was once a time when we lived in harmony. The Sumerians called us Nim. But then, humans turned on us, and started killing us, so we turned on you, and sent a plague of locusts, and we became your worst nightmare, we became your demons, Beelzebub, the lord of the flies. Have you not heard of the prophecies of the Mothman? He is an insectilian warrior. Since the war between insectoids and humans began, there have been many casualties on both sides. But we are winning by far, for we are ultra-terrestrial entities. We use our insectoid antenna to transmit and receive frequencies, we can communicate telepathically and control human thought. We control the minds of leaders of your planet, and they are planning to depopulate the Earth, because they are under our control. We introduced the concept of the caste system to your planet. Why do you think there is hierarchical structure amongst humans that is just like insects? Insects are matriarchal, so the queen is at the top of the hierarchy, followed by the elites, followed by the military, followed by the worker drones. Does that sound familiar? Why do you think you humans live in a colony just like insects live in a colony? You are under our control. The hierarchy of the insectoids and insectilians has the queen bee at the top, followed by the praying mantis beings who are the priests, and the grasshopper beings are their apprentice, followed by the scorpion beings who make up the military, the spider beings who are the scientists, and the ant beings who are the worker drones. You do not stand a chance in this war. The insectoids and insectilians are the strongest beings in the universe, because insects can lift multiple times our own body weight. That is why your greatest boxer, Muhammad Ali, patterned his technique after insects by saying he wanted to float like a butterfly and sting like a bee, because he was being controlled by insectoids and insectilians. We can use our antenna to control all frequencies and technology on your planet. Why do you think they call the programs on your TV and radio entertaining? It is because it is the ants taming you by controlling frequencies through our antenna. Drone technology comes from insectilians, because the original drones were worker insects. Weaving spider insectilians created the World Wide Web internet technology to monitor and control your information. This is why you see spider webs on your dollar money, because your government knows we are in control. Surveillance technology also comes from us insectoids and insectilians, that is why when we are monitoring your conversations, you say the phone is bugged. When you see a roach in your house, that roach was doing reconnaissance surveillance for the insectoids and insectilians. We send insects to crawl on you at night while you sleep, and put implants inside you, and bug your home, and our insect bug spies transmit your thoughts and conversations back to us through their antenna. We even have insects living in your body in the form of parasites from the ingredients in the food you eat. That is why you call it ingredients, because we are just some greedy ants, inside you. We have colonized your mind and body. Insectoids and insectilians come in all sizes, from the microscopic, all the way to gigantic 8 feet tall and 12 feet tall beings. The larger insectoids and insectilians are as old as your solar system, and we have been monitoring the evolution of life on your solar system, as well as many other solar systems. We have colonies on planets orbiting the stars Antares and Bellatrix. We have colonies in the Andromeda Galaxy, and we have colonies on the moons orbiting Saturn. Our cities look like gigantic underground anthills that expand on a global scale. We thrive on planets that have atmospheres where human beings would not be able to survive. We are able to live on planets with high percentages of carbon dioxide, nitrogen, ozone, oxygen, argon, and methane. With all the air pollution you humans have been doing, you are slowly making your planet less habitable for you, and more habitable for us. No. You will not win this war. You will soon be exterminated. Now buzz off. Stop bugging me.